to the Survivor. Last time we had 14 people at Cambridge. This time we have 16 people at Westerner Mansion. This will be an extravagant event. Four returning players.
12 newbies.
This will be an extreme physical, mental, and challenging day. One day, 16 contestants, one Survivor. Survivor Whitewater Season 2, Heroes vs. Villains. We got 16 castaways, 4 returnees. This will be Heroes vs. Villains. I will reveal the tribes. So let me pull them out and see what tribe you guys are on. The Villains tribe. Played host first time, Michael Garcia. On the Rojo tribe, right here, we have JT, you stay put, okay? Cody, join the Rojo tribe. Seth, you're on the Rojo tribe. Christian, stay there. Tyler, you're on the Rojo tribe. Jerry, you're on the Rojo tribe.
What the fuck is going on? Let me go!
Bailey, join the Rojo tribe. And then Connor will stay put. Everybody else, I didn't call your name, is on the Sewell tribe.
Connor, let's go, baby! Holy fuck!
So it's Heroes first villain, it's Heroes and villains.
Welcome to Survivor Season 2, guys. First video a little blurry there, but the rest will not be blurry like that. So as you can see, we have the heroes and villains, and they thought those were going to be the tribes, but they were mixed randomly into the Rojo and Azul tribe. Now I'll be introducing you to all the castaways on this season.
All right, Dion, what do you think of your tribe so far?
Not gonna lie, that twist really threw me off, but
still with Michael. It really worries me. Definitely a dangerous player, but I don't know. I think if I play my cards right, we can make it work. I mean, if we win challenges, I don't have to really do much, but, you know, hopefully I can play my cards right, you know. We'll see what happens, though.
Who would you say is your biggest ally at the moment, if you have any?
Definitely Jake.
Yeah?
For sure. Yeah, for sure.
All right, Kathy, so what's your strategy going on the Survivor here?
Make friends, but keep enemies close.
Perfect. Who do you think is your biggest allies right now, besides, obviously... Well, let me change the question. Do you think there's going to be a big target on you because you're playing with your boyfriend in the same tribe right away?
I don't know. Maybe. But, I mean, let's be real. The relationship doesn't exist in Survivor.
Oh, okay. And then who would you say is your biggest ally right now besides him if he is your ally right now?
Like on my team?
Yeah, on your team.
Oh, I have no idea.
Not sure yet? Just feeling it out?
Yeah.
All right, Caleb. So what's your strategy going on this Survivor?
Let's... Play it easy a little bit at the beginning, don't go too hard, but still be a team player, mostly a team player. That's how I want to play this out.
Who do you think your biggest ally is right now, if you have any?
I've got Michael, Elizabeth, Brady.
Perfect.
Jacob.
Alright. Okay. Alright, Elizabeth, so what's your strategy going on the Survivor?
Definitely to like stay quiet and like be low key. Like I don't want to like make anybody mad or piss someone off and then like get on their bad side, because I feel like that would make me more likely to get voted in. And definitely stick with my friends that I know, because there's obviously a lot of people that I don't know.
So what do you think of your tribe so far, just from the beginning?
The plot twist really threw me off.
Yeah.
So I think the teams are pretty equal, so I think it'll be really interesting to see like who like goes above and beyond.
Who do you think your biggest ally is right now, if you have any yet?
Definitely Michael and Brie, just because I know them.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I know they're on my side. Versus the others, like, they could be on my side, but they could just be playing, so I have to, like, keep my guard up with them, I feel like.
All right, Michael, so what's your strategy going on your first time playing in this?
Okay, so what I think right now is, I for sure, four people locked, it'll be me, Caleb, Elizabeth, and Brie, right? And I think we can rope in either Kathy or Nathan. I have no idea what influence the other guys have on them, but I'm gonna talk to them, feel them out, see what's up. But right now, I'm locked with those other three players, and yeah.
Brie, you're one of the four returning players. What is your strategy this time so you get the W this time?
Just to make alliances with the correct people and win all the challenges that I can.
Who would you say is your biggest allies right now at the moment?
Michael.
All right, Mr. Jake Harris, what is your strategy on the Survivor?
The tribe swap honestly surprised me a lot. I wasn't expecting that, but I think I can get the majority together right off the bat. Yeah, I think Michael might be the first person going home.
Who do you think your biggest ally is right now?
My biggest ally, no doubt, is going to be DeAndre Fairplay. In this game, he's on spice, even in the Hawaiian cheer classes, but we'll see. I'm going to have a lot of fun. Let's hope we win.
All right, man. So do you think there'll be a big target on you knowing that your girlfriend is on the same tribe as you?
I mean, more than likely, but I don't know if they know that, like, we're gay. But
who would you say your biggest ally is right now at the moment?
I mean, like, obviously my girlfriend, Kathy, but, like...
Besides that, maybe?
So far, Dion and Jake have approached me about, like, forming a big three, so...
Perfect. Yeah. All right, Connor, what is your strategy going into Survivor here?
Strategy make it through the first round and all the challenges I've done. I'm either first one out or the last one standing, so hopefully make it to the first round. It should be pretty good. Get everyone to like me, got some new faces, so I'll just try to be the nice guy and maybe play with some people. And then at the end, when I need to, just start taking them out one by one.
All right, Kyle, you're a returning player. What is your strategy going in this time around?
I think my strategy going for this time around is to be insanely like laser focused. Create a good atmosphere within our group that we have, get some good trusting bonds in there, and my one thing from last time is to be more cautious of the other people around me, who might be against me, who might be with me, because last time, not gonna lie, I kind of sucked ass at that. So yeah.
That's would you doing. Say your biggest allies at the moment? If you've been talking to anybody?
I would say probably.
Yeah.
I would say probably Cody, JP, and Bailey.
Alright, sweet. Alright, backwards hat Christian Davis. Is that your name or do you want to go by something else?
Literally,
there's so many names you could call me, you know. When I vote someone out, it's Gangsta Chris. Otherwise, just Milwaukee Chris is fine.
All right, who do you think your biggest ally is at the moment, if you have any?
On my tribe?
Yeah, on your tribe.
On my tribe, I would definitely probably say JP or Cody. I think we have a three-way alliance going on there, already kind of forming. I think we have Kyle and Connor kind of coming in, and obviously Darius as well. We're all working together to stay alive. And I think our biggest enemy has got to be Seth and Bailey. Are you kidding me? You put a couple on a tribe, they're already secluding themselves. I literally see Seth walking around. He's like, is he like over here? No, he's fucking not, dude. It's fucking not. You know why? Because you're not going to fucking party. You know who's going to find the best player in the game, right?
All right, Seth, you're a turning player.
Yes.
What is your strategy going into this time around to make it farther?
No idea, honestly. I guess I need to get to know the guys I don't know for sure. Probably try not to stay too close to my girlfriend, because I feel like that's going to be a big target on our backs, us being together. So really just get to know everybody, get close connections, and try not to lose challenges.
Do you think there's going to be a big target on it since you and Seth are on the same tribe?
Yeah, I do. Well, I think there's going to be a big target on my back because I am the only female on my team. So I think I either need to do really well in the first challenge or I need to find an idol so I'm safe.
What do you think your biggest ally is out here so far besides Seth?
On my team? Or
yeah, on your team at the moment.
I don't know.
If you haven't yet.
Oh, ouch! probably Connor, but I don't know. I don't really know anyone else on my team, so I just gotta perform really well so I can be safe.
All right, Darius, what is your strategy going into here, Survivor Hat Guy?
Just try and get, I don't know, too many people on this tribe. I don't know if I can fully trust them, but just trying to ride it out until I get to merge so I can maybe form some different alliances, because some people in here is,
What is your strategy going into Survivor here?
From watching a bunch of seasons prior, my strategy right now is just build good relationships with everybody and just kind of not put a target on my back, just play cool, just kind of scope everybody out and see what their play style is, and I'll go from there.
All right, and who would you say is your biggest ally at the moment?
My biggest ally right now is I get really good vibes from Christian for sure, and I would probably say JP as well are probably the two guys that I'm closest to right now.
All right, JP, what's your strategy going into this as a returning player versus last time?
Well, last time I didn't get very far, so one of my strategies is I hope everyone remembers I didn't get very far, so that way they kind of feel bad and they let me go on. But I'm kind of concerned because I wanted to be the cool hat guy, because usually they make it a little bit. But Darius also is competing for cool hat guy, but he's on the same team, so I'm going to have to get him out.
Who would you say is your biggest ally at the moment?
Probably cool hat guy, because we got to stick together. And I know it's a conflict of interest, but at the end of the day, we're just going to play. But I think I got some homies around me, you know what I mean? I think I got Cody, I think I got Christian. But at the same time, I thought I had a lot of people last time. You fuckers voted me out.
When each tribe will go out once and you throw at the same time, you're trying to get it just in the hole. The first tribe to get in the hole six times wins. Everybody in your tribe has to go at least once, and then after everyone goes once, anybody can go in a row.
Are we going on the same side?
Yep.
Whoa.
Alright.
Let's go, Dion.
Alright,
move that other one.
Alright.
Yeah, hey, so move that one. You guys don't have to.
There you go.
It's up to you guys.
Alright. Oh, we don't have to? Okay. Just one turn at a time.
Make him up.
Alright, you go first, you go second, then switch up.
Oh, no,
that's
awesome.
Up.
Whoa.
Did we take that off?
Let's go, Nate.
Oh!
There you go, Nate.
Oh!
Kyle, first on the board, got 1-0 here.
Wait,
Kyle, let's go. Oh, Kyle,
she
with the toss?
Not really.
Oh! Let's go!
Phone him off.
Jake, watch out. Jake, watch out.
Did you open it yet?
No, I didn't open it because guess what happened? When I found it, I went, oh shit, and I end up, Cody and freaking Darius are in the kitchen looking too. So what do? I'm like, yeah, looking like the top cabinets up there and stuff, and I just go. And I had it in there, slipping like smooth criminal Michael Jackson, get in my hands, and I just move it back out. out. And then he's like, Cody's like, dude, I think someone has. And I'm like, oh, I think it's got to be Seth. I saw him looking somewhere else when we were looking, and I told him that I think it's Seth.
Hey, guys, so you just saw Rojo win the first challenge. So pre-merge, I allow people to use their phones, and I was added to chats with to talk strategy. Once the merge happens, that is out of the way. I take their phones away. They have to talk in person. So a lot of the strategy before pre-merge, I have to explain what's going down. And also, unfortunately, which I'm really upset about, but we'll get through it, is that I do not have some videos of people getting voted off pre-merge. I still have videos of who voted for who every single elimination, so I'll just have to do it that way. But here we go. Here's some strategy talk from the Sewell Tribe. So there's an inner chat group chat with Dion, Kathy, Nathan, and Jake. It looks like what they're discussing there was what's going to happen for the vote. Looked like they wanted to go Michael, but now they're changing the vote to Elizabeth. And it looks like they're confirming Nathan, Kathy, and Dion that the vote is Elizabeth. And then we have Dion and Jake talking, they don't like Caleb, and they need to find this idol after this vote that's coming up. And then Dion, not sure what Kathy's going to do, and Nathan doesn't know either. Now it looks that Michael is leading a charge to approach Kathy to take out Dion. So now Kathy has a tough decision between Dion and Elizabeth.
Let's hope this works. I'm not really sure about this.
DeAndre, fair play! No!
Please, God, no. Tell me it's not so.
So you guys just saw the first person voted out of Survivor Whitewater Season 2, Dion, my boy. Just got unlucky with everyone thinking it was going to be heroes versus villains, the tribes, and they were not, as they were mixed up immediately. And Dion just was on the wrong side numbers, and Michael led the charge against him, getting Elizabeth, Caleb, Bree, and then Kathy was a deciding vote. Why Nathan, Dion, and Jake tried to get Elizabeth out. Dion just got screwed over, man. Love you, brother. So now you're for the second challenge, separation anxiety. Each tribe will pick one player from their team, and there's a huge pile of M&Ms. They have to sort them by the five different colors, but they have to do it one by one in that exact order that they put it in. They can go backwards or forward, but they have to put it one by one in an order. The first person to get all the colors in there wins immunity.
I don't care.
If someone really wants to do it.
I don't really want to.
Come on, Scott. Step up, son.
No.
Come on.
I think JP comes
to it.
I'm sorry,
little
man.
All right.
Huh?
Let's
go.
Survivor's ready.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let
pretty even right now.
Let's go, JP.
Come on,
JP.
Speed up, fucko.
Yes, sir.
Adam,
you got
it. Stay calm, Gabby.
Sulby Rojo. Good job, Kathy. Come on, JP. So unfortunately, I can't send any strategy from this round via text message because nobody added me to their chats, Rojo tribe. But what it looks like is, it looks like Seth and Bailey are in trouble. They're the couple in the tribe on the outs of the eight people, and they were caught looking for some idols before, so the target is on their back. But I know Seth is gunning for Christian or Kyle. And Bailey and him have to decide who they're trying to get over to vote with them to try to take one of them out.
All right, yeah. Rojo, Cody, how did it feel to lose this last challenge?
It didn't feel the best, especially after winning the first one. I felt nice not really having to worry about anything. Well, that's the game, so now we have to vote somebody out.
Seth, would you say that people are looking for idols on the track?
It doesn't matter. No one cares if we're looking or not. Everyone's just
everyone's
going
looking.
Everywhere. And they're not really trying to hide it.
JP, how did it feel that you lost the challenge for your time?
Oh, it felt great. What do you think I'm supposed to say?
Suck ass! Whoa! You gotta try a little harder next time, maybe.
Oh, I'm sorry, Kathy has, like, the fucking Eminem reflexes of a goddamn spider.
This is a PG rated show, mind you. We gotta bleep all that out.
You can swear if you want, Kyle.
There might
be. Fuck!
I'm just saying.
Whoa, Kyle!
There is a chance I had more M&Ms than them. I'm just gonna say. I think there's a clear she might have grabbed more than one at a time, you know?
Gotta get rid of the other elements. Is
it's gonna be me this time, I can guarantee it. I can't even pick up a fucking card. Voting for Kyle.
So I can talk shit or no?
Yeah.
I'm not gonna do that.
Oh!
I'm not gonna do that. This is a big ass Sharpie. Okay, where do I put this thing?
Show it to me.
Don't start throwing my name out there and don't start looking at me when I'm looking for the idol. Not cool.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna really suck if everyone doesn't vote this way.
God bless. Did I put it in here? Strictly business, boy. Nothing personal, just don't think you have the idol.
Well, Seth, you were the second person out, man. You played really good last time to the merge. This time got out too early. I think it just, you got screwed over on the swap in the beginning too with your girlfriend being there, and you just were up against the wall. Wish you would have found that idol. But now, folks, I didn't get a record either. But after one vote of each tribe, we switch back to heroes versus villains. So all the remaining heroes are on a tribe, and all the remaining villains are on a tribe. Yeah. Hey guys, now for this challenge, it's a minute to win a game called Yank It. Each tribe has to pick a person, and it will be four red solo cups and 3 index cards, and you have to stack them up how you would like. And you have to pull one index card off at a time to get the cups to go down in a row into a pile perfectly. The first try to get do this 3 times wins.
War immunity, Heroes versus Bellum. Survivors ready, go! Take your time, it doesn't need to be a rush. You want to get it down perfect.
Except for you, Cody.
Oh,
yeah, make right. More mistakes.
You gotta pull that cup off.
Oh, this is gonna be a lot more heavy than I thought it was. This is
gonna be hard.
Yeah. Shit.
Sorry. You're good.
You got it.
You guys gotta pull it out quick.
It's gonna be so hard. I should have gone first.
If you guys take too long, we'll probably cut it down to just 2 people. It's hard, but once you get it, you'll get it.
Yes!
What
is it?
You can
put
it.
Oh!
Hey!
Yes!
Oh! You can swap out something going or
I got you with that. That was a great
spell. Oh, yeah. That was amazing.
First one to get through. That was
awesome.
We can catch up.
How many times do we have to do this?
3. So, like, I shouldn't play your time, sorry. There we go!
So can I put this back up like that, or I have to start all over and start over?
You got it,
you got it.
Unless you knock one off.
Alright. You had it, you got it.
You're right there, now you just do this.
Get the touch.
You got this.
There we go, nice. Come on. There we go!
Kyle, don't do it!
On being nervous, you know, I was the last person to kind of go, so we'll see what happens. It's kind of up to anything.
All right, it is time to vote. Second vote, Michael.
That's not
me. Third vote, JP.
Ooh. This isn't going well.
So two on JP. Fourth vote, Michael. 2-2. Fifth vote, JP.
I see how this is going.
3-2, JP. Michael. 3-3. One vote left. Third person voted out of Survivor, Heroes versus Villains, Whitewater. Michael.
No.
Oh.
Michael has to bring your torch.
Why would you do that to the owner? This is a sad day. I mean, that's a sad day.
Michael, unfortunately, the tribe has spoken.
Especially
one host, 2-1.
Michael, you're the third person voted out of Survivor, Heroes versus Villains. You played a pretty hard game in the beginning. You just couldn't get Kathy to line with you. She was with you, and she completely flipped on you here, going out 4-3. You're a good player, good host, but you are out, Michael.
All right, guys, now for this challenge. It's ping-pong-tac-toe, which was in the first season of Survivor Whitewater. The tribes will be going one at a time, bouncing one to try to get three in a row across, diagonal, or along the line. It's going to be hard to see the X's and O's here, but just breathe with me and you'll see who gets the victory in this challenge, folks.
For the strategic plays here, but it sounds like Cody and Jake are talking to Caleb about voting Bailey off, but everyone looks like they want to vote Caleb off. I know Jake had some bad blood with Caleb in the beginning of the Sewell tribe, couldn't trust him. So it looks like it's either Caleb or Bailey right now. It just depends if they have enough to go Caleb or Bailey, and if Jake and Cody are telling the truth.
Bailey, you're not the one going home tonight. Caleb's the one going home. Don't ever betray me. That's what happens.
Caleb, buddy. Sorry, man. Went out 4-3. Cody, Darius, and Jake tricked you. I think Bree was a part of that plan, too. To go with them and vote Bailey off, even though they were had the numbers to get you off. Apparently betrayed Jake, and he came for you, man, and got you. You're playing a sneaky game, underrated player, I think, and best of luck next time, man. For this challenge, we did not get it recorded, but what it was you had to shoot from here, make it into these Kleenex boxes, and then we had flip cup of three each. Christian and Darius went in here, and Darius beat Christian. Christian could not flip all three cups. Then there was a riddle under each one. The heroes had what belongs to you, but other people use it more than you. And it was first name, and the heroes won the challenge.
How did it feel, you guys?
Great.
Felt good.
Very nice. How did it feel?
Very nice. It was great teamwork. I love this.
Got the riddle. You got the flip.
Feels good to beat Gangsta Chris, not going to lie.
Yeah, he's talking. Was he talking a lot that he's better than you?
Mad trash. He thinks he's the better Sigma Pi, but that's me.
Last time here, you won't hear... see or hear any strategy from the players, just from my perspective, from what was happening, what I heard. Elizabeth's back and swelled to six villains remaining. It's her, Nathan, Kathy, JP, Christian, and Connor. And Elizabeth's got to hope she has an idol or finds one or something, otherwise she's in deep trouble here.
Strictly business, I don't know what else to say.
He already voted for me, so fuck it.
Oh, oh yeah. They're in shade. There's beef.
Okay. These votes suck. Still strictly business.
Elizabeth, you're the fifth person out. You just had no allies left on your tribe. Michael, Caleb, Seth was out, and Connor's not wasn't on your side anymore, apparently. He said the vote was tough, but yeah, that was it, Elizabeth. Thanks for playing. Definitely another super underrated player. I think he could do very well if he played again. So that's it for episode 1 of Survivor Whitewater Season 2, Heroes vs. Villains, called The Pre-Merge. Please subscribe and to this channel, Idol Identifiers. There will be 2 more episodes for this season. And please like this video if you enjoyed it. Leave comments. Who is your fan favorite? Check out the Instagram at idol.identifiers. Who's your favorite player left? Who do you think is going to win? Find out next time.
Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode.
Next time on Survivor, we have made the merge, and people are excited to be here. Some people are even surprised they made it this far and are happy. Relationships will be trusted.
Hopefully I get to the end with them.
And will deals be made? We'll see next time on Survivor.